Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau insists Canada will not be intimidated by China. That's after tit-for-tat diplomatic expulsions by both countries. Canada first expelled a Chinese diplomat who was allegedly planning to intimidate a Canadian lawmaker. Beijing called the move unreasonable before ordering a Canadian diplomat to leave Shanghai as a reciprocal countermeasure. There are now fears the latest flare-up could have economic repercussions. Trudeau told reporters he understands there is retaliation, but his government intends to do what they must in protecting Canadians from foreign interference. Former Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan will appear in a special court Wednesday to answer graft charges, a day after his shock arrest prompted violent nationwide protests. Tempers have appeared to cool, but there is a huge security presence across the capital, particularly outside the so-called police lines where the special court will convene. Khan's attention follows months of political crisis and came hours after he was rebuked by the military for alleging that a senior officer had been involved in a plot to kill him. Local media have reported two deaths in clashes between Khan supporters and security forces. Khan has repeatedly denied corruption accusations, claiming he's being politically persecuted. A journalist working for Agence France-Presse was killed Tuesday by rocket fire in eastern Ukraine. The French news agency confirmed the death of its Ukraine video coordinator, Armand Soldin, in an attack at a town near Bakhmut, which is the epicenter of the fighting in eastern Ukraine for several months. Soldin was with four colleagues who are all unhurt. Soldin had been living in Ukraine since September, leading AFP's Ukraine war coverage and traveling regularly to the front lines in the east and the south. The Federal Bureau of Investigation has dismantled a network of malicious software created by Russia's elite spies. That's according to senior U.S. law enforcement officials. They say FBI technical experts identified and disabled the malware known as Snake, which, according to officials, is used by Russia's intelligence service to spy on computers around the world. Authorities say the spies behind the malware are part of a notorious hacking group, which has been active for two decades against a variety of NATO-aligned targets. Russian officials have yet to comment, but Moscow routinely denies carrying out cyber espionage operations. Former U.S. President Donald Trump found liable for sexually abusing and defaming former magazine writer E. Jean Carroll in the 1990s. The nine-member jury also ordered Trump to pay Carroll $5 million in damages. Trump was absent throughout the trial, called the verdict a disgrace and a continuation of what he claims is the greatest witch hunt of all time. His spokesman says they will appeal the decision. This is the latest legal trouble for Trump amid his bid to retake the White House in 2024. Embattled Republican Congressman George Santos now facing criminal charges. CNN reports Santos is expected to appear as soon as Wednesday in federal court in New York's Eastern District, where the charges have been filed. The Associated Press, meanwhile, reports that Santos is in a brief interview. Said he was unaware of the allegations. The exact nature of the charges against Santos remains unclear, but federal prosecutors have been examining false statement allegations in the lawmaker's campaign filings.